We said, here's the pathway forward. We've laid a positive foundation to move Wisconsin forward, and people want to continue down that path. We need to do that nationally as well. Which goes to my second point. We need to be more relevant as Republicans.
Governor Walker in Iowa last Thursday night, speaking to a premier Republican event, the annual Polk County GOP dinner in Des Moines. Walker says his friend, Iowa Governor Terry Branstad, invited him. But Walker is considered to be a potential presidential candidate, and Iowa, of course, is an important early test in that process. So what's the significance of his visit? We're asking the man who knows Iowa politics better than anyone, David Yepsen, the former Des Moines Register political reporter, now with Southern Illinois University. But we found him back in Iowa this week. David, it's good to have you on the program. Help us understand just how big a deal is this event in Des Moines.
No, I think it's a big deal. I mean, I think it's significant when candidates come to this event, and I think it's a big political event in Iowa's largest county. So it's, if you're thinking about running for president, it's a good crowd to be in front of.
Who's been there in the past?
Well, a lot. Historically, the Ronald Reagan dinner attracts all sorts of Republican presidential candidates. The better question is who hasn't been there. It's a place to be.
Give us your sense of how Governor Walker might play with the people who participate in the Iowa caucus process.
Well, I think he'd play very well. I mean, this visit is, I call this kind of a visit, a deal me a hand visit. He probably in his own mind hasn't made it clear, understood whether he wants to run for president. It's a long way away. But this signals to Iowa Republicans all over the state that he wants to be considered as a potential candidate. And I think he would play very well. He obviously had a high profile during his fights with the labor movement in Wisconsin, and that plays very well with rank and file Republicans. We're not talking about the Iowa electorate as a whole here. We're talking about a group of 100 to 120 to 150,000 activist Republicans. They're very conservative, and I think he would do very well with them.
He has a background, the son of a minister. He has not agreed with the president, I think, on a single major issue. This is all good stuff for him with the people who participate in the caucuses, isn't it?
Yes, it is. And I think it's important, too, Mike, to understand that he's got a bit of a regional advantage in Iowa. First of all, if you look at the history of the caucus process, being from the Middle West can help. It's not a guarantee, as Tommy Thompson proved. But if you look at who's won, I mean, Bob Dole, Walter Mondale, in both parties, being from the neighborhood is helpful. So that's good for him because he can bring supporters into Iowa to knock on doors and to work crowds. It's very helpful in that regard. And secondly, I think it's helpful because he understands the political culture. The political cultures of the two states are very similar. The Republican parties in the two states are very similar. So he can go into a small Iowa town and feel just like he's right home in Wisconsin. So I think he'll be a good fit in that regard.
The governor said he was there Thursday at the invitation of Iowa's governor, Terry Branstad. Does it make any difference that they're friends? Does that help the governor? Does it give him entree? Or is Branstad just stay out of the matter in Iowa?
Well, historically, Branstad has stayed out of this. Governors in Iowa and both parties over the years in these caucuses generally don't endorse. It can be seen as tilting the playing field in favor of a candidate without really providing that candidate much benefit. We don't have political machines in this state. Nobody delivers anything. So it's good for Terry Branstad's attitude has been, y'all come and welcome them and help raise money. And so I think it's good that he's a friend of Governor Walker's, but I don't think it delivers any votes to the governor in a caucus fight.
And we should point out other Republican potential candidates have been to Iowa already, have they not?
Right. I mean, it never ends in this state.
Yeah.
Bobby Jindal, Rick Santorum. The caucus campaign is a constant in both parties in this state.
And it's still, Iowa still holds the same significance in your opinion? You've covered this event for a long time. Is it still as important as it once was?
Well, it depends. It ebbs and flows. I think, we're talking about the selection of an American president. For better or worse, this is the first contest. And so it naturally becomes important. They had some problems counting the results last time on the Republican side. There's a lot of controversy about the way the caucuses are run, about the caucuses themselves. But at the end of the day, it remains first. And if that's the case, then it's going to be significant. There'll be media people there. The candidates will be here, and game on. There'll be a first event here. It will be important for candidates to do well here as a springboard into New Hampshire and in South Carolina. So I think doing well in Iowa is important. It's hard to lose here and keep going. But just because you win here doesn't mean you go to win the nomination.
David Yepsen, the Dean of Political Reporters in Iowa, and now with Southern Illinois University. We appreciate your time. Thanks very much for being with us.
Thank you.
Next, how people in Wisconsin feel about immigration reform. And for political news and information throughout the week, follow me at Mike Goucher on Twitter.